Hi, this is Jasmine from Entech, and today we're going to show you how to create your own fixtures in our lighting software, EMU. Stay till the end because throughout the entire video, we'll be showing you simple tips and tricks to make using EMU faster and easier. Before we dive right in, if you want to hear more tips and tricks or just want to stay up to date with Entech news and products and be notified when we go live, then hit that subscribe button and the bell so you don't miss a thing. EMU has an extensive lighting fixture library powered by Creset. However, this does not have every single lighting fixture out there. So, we have updated EMU to give you the ability to create your own custom fixture. Please note that this is a premium feature, so if you are using the free version of EMU, you will have to pay for a subscription to be able to customize your own fixtures. There are multiple ways of doing this, so we will show you the three ways to customize your fixture. You can start from scratch, combine multiple fixtures together, or customize a fixture that already exists. Which method you use is dependent on your lights and your own personal preference. For this tutorial, we will start from scratch. So when we first open up EMU, this is the screen that you'll see. So because this is a premium feature, just make sure you've got premium license activated on your machine. Everything that we're going to be doing is done in the patch section. So jump up there. For this first one, we're going to start from scratch and do a simple RGB fixture. So to start a custom fixture, press save as new custom fixture. And then this will create a fixture in the folder custom fixtures. All custom fixtures that you create will go into this folder. So make sure that as you go, you name them correctly. And if you want to access them quickly later, just press the star. This will make it heaps easier later when you want to find your custom fixtures. So to create a simple RGB, just put RGB as the name, then press add fader. So for this, I know we want to have three faders. So we want the first fader as fader type RGB, mapping name, red. The second one, same RGB, green. And the third one, RGB, blue. And then we go save custom fixture. Then this creates a three channel fixture that you can just put in your patch timeline and you've got red, green, and blue. So if we jump out of the patch, then you've got red, green, and blue. Jump back into the patch. Just as a quick tip, you can rearrange any of these faders. Just hold down on the three dots and then you can just move them up and down and rearrange them as you want. And then if you press save custom fixture, move it into your patch, then it'll be blue, green, and red. If you didn't want this one anymore, then just press delete. So that's how you create a super simple custom fixture. So let's get a little bit more complicated. So say if you didn't want just numbers when you scroll up and down on the fader. You actually wanted words in there. So what you do is we want to adjust this blue fader. So adjust that. Save as new custom fixture, because that'll start a new custom fixture. I want to rename this one to Zoom, for example. Then instead of having RGB, I want to put Control. And the mapping name, instead of typical, I want to change that to custom. And then it's down here where we can put the alphabetical label that we want on the main screen. So back into patch, say if we wanted, so no function is between 0 and 10, add, then we've got zoom, which is between 11 and 100. Then we've got large size, which is between 101 and 150. Then we've got small size, which is between 151 and 200. And then we've got recycle, zoom, between 201 and 255, and then press add. Then if we save custom fixture, add that into our patch, go back out, and we'll see it says no function, zoom, large size, small size, and recycle zoom. So that's just if you wanted words on this slider instead of having values. So let's go back into our patch. Now we're going to do the second method of how to create a custom fixture, and that's by combining multiple fixtures together. So now we're going to go out and we're going to find a fixture that is got part of what we need. So say if it's smart pixel dot, 8-bit, move that into our patch. So that's got the red, green, and blue that we want. Then if we go back out and we want something that has pan and tilt and everything else that's in our fixture. So the Falcon does with the 15 channels. So that's got the pan, the tilt, the zoom. So that's got everything we need. So now we want to hold shift and select both of the fixtures. And we want to create custom fixture. Now, this will create a fixture with the red, green, blue, pan, tilt, zoom, control, and everything that we need. So I want to change that to RGB, pan, tilt, and save as new custom fixture. So now this is an 18-channel fixture that has everything in that we need. And again, you can go through and you can move anything around based on the structure of the light itself. And that one's called RGB, pan, and tilt. Now, let's look at the third way to create a custom fixture, and that's to simply edit an already existing feature. So let's find a fixture that is similar to what we want. So we've got this one, and then we've got the 7-channel mode. Put that into our patch. And so this one's got pan, tilt, dimmer, strobe, color wheel. But instead of having pan, tilt, and dimmer, what happens if we want to adjust ours to say RGB, strobe, colors? We want to select the fader that we want to adjust and create custom fixture. That'll create a new fixture. So we'll call this one RGB strobe. And then save as new custom fixture. And now we can go in, and so it's RGB strobe. So now we can go in and we can adjust this pan tilt to RGB red, RGB green, and RGB blue. You can also go through, and because this one says value closed open strobe, and all of that, so you can adjust all of that. So this method is really good if you've got a fixture that is not in the Cresset library, but it is very close to something else. You can just change anything that you need to make it fit the actual light that you've got. So something else you can also do is you can import and export custom fixtures. So they import and export as a .femu file. So this means that you can share them between computers, or if someone else has created a fixture, you can bring that into your own library. So that's how you create a custom fixture in EMU. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and if there's anything that you think we've missed, just put it in the comments below. Otherwise, if you have enjoyed this video, then hit the like and subscribe button. If you want to hear more tips, tricks, or just want to stay up to date with EnTech news and products and be notified when we go live, then hit that subscribe button and bell so you don't miss a thing. The link to download EMU is also in the description, and you can find out more from our website.